everyone, and happy Tuesday. Today is February 9th, and as you can see by the board behind me, today we're going to wrap up our learning on text structure by taking a quiz. All right, so today we'll be able to see how well you guys can do at identifying text structure. You can see in the message it says, today we will continue Unit 2 about analyzing informational articles by taking a quiz to see how good we are at identifying which text structure was used to organize information in a selection of passages. The do now reminds you to make sure that you write down your homework. And so the only work you need to do today is make sure that you have completed that quiz. And also for all the in-class students, I will be collecting your Freak the Mighty books. And today you guys will be getting your copies of Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. Let's scroll down. Now today, just like yesterday, we're not adding any new notebook pages, but it is going to be very important that you use notebook pages 32 through 37 to do your quiz today. I want to remind all of you that you can use your notebook on your quiz, and you should. If you don't use your notebook, you're not going to do as well as you could if you did use your notebook. So let's scroll down right here. You'll see activity number one. Simply, today you're taking the text structure quiz. You will complete this quiz on Google Classroom. And here are the four directions. Number one, read each passage. Number two, use your knowledge of text structure along with your notebook to determine what text structure was used to craft each. Step three, pick the text structure used to organize the passage. Step four, take the time to review your work before hitting the submit button. It's very important that you guys take your time. To find this assignment, you will click on the Mr. Trumbull's ELA Google Classroom. You will find the assignment under the Classworks tab. So if I click on the Classwork tab, it is right here under Unit 2 Assignments. You can see on my teacher page that there are only two more assignments in Unit 2 after our text structure quiz. We're getting very close to being done with Unit 2. The last topic we are going to cover is primary versus secondary sources. All right, so you're going to scroll down. You're going to find the one that says quiz for text structure. All right, I'm going to click it to open it. And again, we have directions here. It says read each passage and select the text structure used to organize the information in that paragraph. So here I will open it up. Okay, so here is your quiz. And don't overlook the picture. The picture kind of gives you a little bit of a clue. All of these passages have to do with camping in some way or another, camping, fire. All right, primarily they center around camping. All right, one of these passages, all right, is going to be written using the description text structure. One passage is written using the compare and contrast text structure. Another using the order and sequence. Another using problem and solution. And another using cause and effect. So each one of the text structures is only going to be used once. All right. So your job is to make sure that you read each passage carefully. All right. And as you read the passage, make sure that you are using your notebook, that you are going back into the notebook. You're using your clue words. You're using your definitions. You're making comparisons with the examples that we put in our notebook. All right. If you're doing this quiz in class, I should be able to see you going into your notebook, flipping back and forth, really critically thinking about the passages here in your quiz. Okay, you should be taking your time. These passages are a bit longer than the ones that were on your practice from yesterday. So take your time to really become a critical thinker and to analyze the passages. All right, there's only five questions. So this quiz is worth 10 points. each passage is worth 2 points. So if you miss even one, that's going to drop your score down significantly. So it's really important that you take your time on each passage, all right, and that you are selecting the best answer for each question. And then at the bottom, of course, you guys know, hit the submit button. But don't do it before you check your answers, you go back in, you make sure that you've done absolutely the best work possible. Okay. Moving forward, this is going to wrap up text structure. And as I said earlier in the video, we are going to be moving on to our last topic, the last topic that we're going to look at in this unit, which is all about informational text, is looking at primary versus secondary sources. All right, so more on that to come tomorrow. Good luck on the quiz, and I will see you guys here tomorrow. Bye-bye.